In this video, I will show you how to make soya veggie kebabs, which is very rich in protein. For this, we need soya granules. I'm taking some soya granules in a bowl and add the hot water and leave it for 20 to 30 minutes. After 20-30 minutes, the soya granules will expand. Then I'm going to squeeze the excess water from it and it looks like this. Then we need 3 boiled potatoes, which I already mashed the potatoes, 1 small chopped onion, some chilies to taste, and 10 gram of grated ginger. I'm taking a bowl and adding a mashed potatoes into it. Then add your soya granules. Then add chopped onion. Then chilies to taste and ginger. Adding some coriander leaves. Add salt to taste. Add 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder. Add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric. Add 1 teaspoon of coriander seeds, also known as sabu dhania. 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper. 1 teaspoon of coriander powder. 1 teaspoon of jeera powder, which also known as cumin powder. 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. 1/2 teaspoon of dry mango powder, also known as amchur. And very important, 2 tablespoon of besan, which is chickpea flour. Mix all the ingredients well. I'm mixing it how we are making a dough, so that all the ingredients mix well together. Once all the ingredients mix well, I'm taking a small amount and making a tikki. Actually, I'm making to put in a burger bun. But you can also make a small kebabs for the snacks. So how you make your tikkis, you can roll on the plate to have the smooth sides. Similarly, I make all the tikkis for the big one. I make 9 tikkis out of the material we have. Then take oil in the pan for the shallow frying. I'm not going to deep fry these tikkis, so I'm shallow frying only. Then take 2 teaspoon of corn flour and mix with the water to make a smooth paste. This is required because I need to dip the tikkis in the corn flour. Then I will shallow fry this. It helps to bind the material together and give a crisp to the tikkis. Similarly, I am doing with the other one, so I am frying 3 tikkis together. Once done on the one side, we are flipping the tikki to the other side. So need to ensure that we are cooking on the both the sides until it's dark golden brown in color. This look, our tikkis is done. So I'm taking it out and putting on the paper towel to soak the excess oil. Similarly, I will cook my another tikkis. And our soya tikkis are ready, which is very good in taste. If you like my recipes, please don't forget to subscribe my channel and click the bell icon to get the updates on my videos.